Mheshimiwa. Now we move on and focus on what is happening across the counties. The Parliamentary Committee on Constitutional Implementation Oversight is seeking public views on the Constitution Amendment Bill number 40 that proposes that elected members of Parliament and County Assembly can be appointed to the Executive. Details of this and other stories in our County News Wrap.
Speaking after a public participation session in Lokiriama Hall in Turkana Central, Constitutional and Implementation Oversight Committee Chair Jeremiah Kioni said that the views collected will be implemented accordingly.
Constitution Amendment Bill number 40, which is proposing to amend the articles of the Constitution so that elected members of Parliament are appointed into the executive and they become the cabinet ministers.
Meanwhile, a multi-agency task force has directed the Office of the Director of Criminal Investigations to open probe on two senior teachers at Thiru Primary School in Laikipia West, where three pupils were allegedly tied to a tree as punishment. The task force, led by Nyahururu Sub-County Deputy County Commissioner Moses Muroki, had on Wednesday morning arrived at the school that is located about 15 kilometers from Nyahururu Town, where statements were recorded from teachers and students. In the pictures that went viral on social media, three pupils are seen tied to a tree in the school compound.
We came here to investigate a case where there was some cruelty which was done to three pupils of this primary school, Thiru Primary School, by teachers as a way of discipline.
We're going to open protection and care file and trace the progress and the recovery of the affected children, so to make sure that the trauma and the humiliation they went through does not reoccur or keep reoccurring and affect their future lives.
What has happened, we are condemning it, and what we are saying is no one has been declared guilty of any offense until the due process, that is the discipline process, has been undertaken.
In other news, two suspected mobile phones thieves caught on CCTV camera in Kakamega while on the act have been arraigned in a Kakamega court. However, the two denied all charges before Judge Joseph Nururi, who declined to grant them bail in light of threats to the complainant. The suspects are seen on the CCTV cutting away mobile phones from the electronic shop they had broken into. The case will be heard on 19th October this year. Finally, the ongoing efforts by the government to increase forest cover has received a major boost with the World Wide Fund for Nature moving to create new forests in Lake Naivasha Basin. According to Program Coordinator in Naivasha Landscape, Caroline Jiro, the project will be carried out under the Lake Naivasha Basin Restoration Program.
This is an carbon inserting project funded by Coop Switzerland, and it aims at creating new forests in Naivasha, looking at areas that have been degraded for the last 10 years.
Apparently, we are having quite a number of industries and factories coming up in the upper catchment. These are timber factories, milk processing plants, food processing plants, specifically potatoes. And these industries and factories are really using so many types of chemicals to process their products.